Well, first of all, the government has invested heavily in Kenya on security, both human and technology, but also investment in equipment and vehicles. Also, making sure that the policemen are seen visibly on any site. That's very crucial because people will feel secure. And then the investment in CCTVs, the investment on making sure that there is rapid response rather than an issue, so that can assure people action is going to be taken. Those are the things that will mitigate insecurity. But also there is a lot of blown out of proportion media coverage on perception. It's not safe. Everybody I've met the last 8 years since I've become a Minister of Tourism, they say when they come to Kenya, there's a lot of fear, but unfortunately when they're here, they feel secured. And they want to come back again and again. So these are the things that eventually clears the image of the destination. Well, potential always grows, it changes. Yeah, we have a target of 5 million by 2030. Last year we clocked our best numbers, which is over 2 million. So yes, we have all the strategies in place to increase the numbers. We have not even targeted the region. Most of our visitors come from Europe and the USA. Almost 55% of our visitors are outside the continent. We also believe that the continent has the potential because of the middle class growing. Countries have improved their infrastructure and education system. People aspire to travel. So these are the potential that we are still yet to tap. Although we have realized also domestic tourism has become very powerful. Kenya already, through its difficult time, has been sustained by domestic tourism. So this is another big market that we are yet to maximize. Well, first of all, we are privileged to have been the first capital of Kenya. We are the pioneers of Kenya's capital. Yes, definitely, we have Nairobi now, and we appreciate we're not only a second city, but the economic hub of the region. We are the gateway for East and Central Africa. We have a very vibrant port, and every day we're improving the efficiency of that port. What we need most was to make sure that we lay the infrastructure to support the city plus the port operations. In the last 50 years, very little investment was done in infrastructure. In the last 5 years, we have invested heavily. In fact, most of the infrastructure is yet to be ready, in the next couple of years. So this will then make Mombasa as a proper port city, but also supports the hinterland of not only Kenya, but East and Central Africa. So yes, what we need also to improve here is to make sure that the county or the city council works through garbage collection, through traffic management. These are crucial things that can kill the city, because if we don't have garbage being collected or we don't have the traffic management rules, then the people will be frustrated to come into the city. Well, first of all, it's a blessing that we have invested this almost $4 billion on the railway, which we call it the SGR. This has benefited us tourism. Today, the domestic market, the domestic segment of tourism is depending on this train, particularly coming to the beach. Most of the hotels in Mombasa are being filled because of the domestic market. Secondly, we have brought efficiency and cost of doing business down by improving the efficiency of the port. Before we had the train, you used to deliver your cargo within 21 days. Now, within 4 or 5 days, your cargo is with you because of the efficiency of the train. There's nowhere in the world that you have a port and then the port detains your cargo, and then it takes you 21 days to release it eventually the cost of that detention of cargo and the cost of the delay and the demurrages will go to the consumer. So the inflation rate will go down now, the cost of products and services will go down, and the efficiency has improved in Mombasa Port, including the collection of revenue by our Kenyan National Revenue Authority. So these are positive things we have done. Yet we need to actually make sure it synchronizes with everything. The local economy, the business community to appreciate the changes have a positive effect in the economy. So far, we have seen the effect by the reduction of the number of days containers are handled in Mombasa Airport from 21 to 4 days. Well, the best thing what we have in Kenya is the human capital. We have people who are highly educated, they're sophisticated, they have the capacity to make sure your investment is worthwhile.